Hello and welcome to another edition of our ETF Insight series, where we chat with innovative leaders from the ETF and digital assets ecosystem. Today, I'm really happy to be joined by Felix Schleimer, who is Associate Director of Investment Solutions at Saiba Bank. So Felix, why don't we start with you telling us about Saiba Bank and your role there?
Absolutely. Hi, thanks for having me on. So Saiba Bank is a fully regulated Swiss bank, just like normal Swiss banks are. But the one difference is that we have decided to specialize a little bit into digital assets and cryptos. We were one of the first to be issued with a banking license specifically for cryptos. And what I do in my team, Investment Solutions, is essentially a redefined name for asset management. So we help institutional investors who want to have exposure to crypto, whether they want to do it themselves or whether they wish to outsource that to us. But we do everything from build products in the marketplace for investors to invest in, run discretionary mandates or run AMCs and help with white labeling products. So really anything within the space for institutional sites who want to start dipping their feet but want to do so with a regulated partner, that falls into our lap.
So one of the things that Saiba Bank, I'm on your newsletter list, and a couple weeks ago, mentioned that last year the dominance of Bitcoin had dropped significantly from about, I think it was 74% to 39% compared to some of the other crypto assets. Can you expand on that a little bit and just shed a little color on that?
Absolutely. I think we have a really interesting chart that our head of research, Longchamp, has shown a couple of times. And actually, if we look at Bitcoin's dominance over the last, let's say, 7 years, it has decreased even more significantly. You know, when if you look back, I think it's 7 years, Bitcoin's dominance was almost the only cryptocurrency out there in the market in terms of market cap that was significant, but also recognized. And what we've seen afterwards, which I think is what drove me to the space in general, is that this cryptos have not just become this store of value that Bitcoin is associated with. There's a reason why Bitcoin has been referred to as the digital version of gold in a portfolio. But actually, when blockchain, which is a really interesting technology itself, there are more protocols and more technologies being built on blockchains. And a common misunderstanding is that they want to have the blockchain without the cryptocurrency, but you can't have one without the other. So as more technologies come out and more technologies are being built, such as Ethereum, Polkadot, Cardano, Avalanche, all the other 15,000 there are at the moment, naturally there's a shift and an allocation in the market cap that has gone from Bitcoin and onto these what we call alternative or altcoins.
Great.
It's really just a maturity of the marketplace. Now, I think one conversation that I often have with investors is I reference the IT bubble of the early 2000s a lot here, where there were so many IT companies coming out there. There's some similarity with the altcoins at the moment, but nonetheless, I think that this is just the emergence of the market space. It's very hard to predict which coins or which tokens or technologies will have done really, really well in a 5-year time horizon. But I think nonetheless, we are kind of at the cusp now where this is starting to become a bigger than just Bitcoin.
Right. And you mentioned in your response gold, which is parlays into our next question, which is, so, you know, obviously in the press, there's a lot of comparison and it's generally Bitcoin as the cryptocurrency versus gold and how they perform against each other. So if we're looking at both of those as a similar hedge within a portfolio, how should investors be looking at the other cryptocurrencies that are out there, especially since we generally in the press, they're mentioning Bitcoin as opposed to one of the other names that you mentioned?
Well, I think at the end of the day, the benefit that cryptocurrencies have in a portfolio at the moment is it's a wonderful portfolio diversification method. Adding a bit of Bitcoin can increase your Sharpe ratio quite dramatically. Diversifying into multiple, we have one of our flagship products is a diversified crypto index, and that doubles your Sharpe ratio by having a 2% allocation towards it within a portfolio. And that just highlights how within a portfolio, any investor will know that if they only expose themselves to 100% equities, they ride more volatility. There is more risk associated to it. So that's why we have this traditional 60-40 portfolio, which perhaps is being slightly turned upon its head at the moment. I agree that I think gold has a very relevant and a very good anti-inflationary hedge. proposition within a portfolio. I think Bitcoin does too. And because they're not very correlated to each other, you almost get a double whammy from both Bitcoin and gold within a portfolio. But like I said, I think having a small allocation towards cryptocurrencies beyond Bitcoin, because at the end of the day, when you're talking about portfolio diversification, one can't simply say I've diversified my portfolio by having three different stocks in my portfolio. One diversifies with different types. And just like that, when it comes to the crypto exposure, one should, any sensible investor should look into the diversification benefits that all the other cryptocurrencies have as well.
Thank you, Felix, so much for your time, and loved your insights. For anyone who's watching, if you want to watch more of these videos, you can go to our website, which is blackwatersearch.com. Thank you again, Felix, and thank you everyone for watching.